Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It is about understanding. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about the relation among the inscribed angles of a circle. What could be the objectives? First, we will determine the relation among the inscribed angles and arcs. Second, we will identify the measure among the inscribed angles and arcs. Let us recall semicircle. Semicircle is equal to 180 degrees. Well, circle is equal to 360 degrees. If the measure of the central angle DBC is equal to 40 degrees, let us identify the measure of the angle ABD. So the solution, the linear pairs are supplementary. So it means if that is supplementary, the total must be 180 degrees. So let us solve. The measure of the angle ABD plus the measure of the angle DBC is equal to 180 degrees. So what could be the measure of the angle DBC? So let us replace. So the angle DBC is equal to 40 degrees. And then copy the measure of the angle ABD and then copy 180 degrees. So let us solve for the measure of the angle ABD. Copy. Measure of angle ABD equals copy 180 degrees. Positive 40 going to right, that is addition property of equality, so that becomes negative 40. 180 degrees minus 40 degrees, the measure of the angle ABD is equal to 140 degrees. How about the vertical angles are equal? So it means if the value or the measure of the angle ABD is equal to 140 degrees, so it means the measure of the angle EBC is also equal to 140 degrees because angle ABD is equal to angle EBC. How about the other vertical angles? BBC is equal to 40 degrees, so it means the value or the measure of the angle ABE is also equal to 40 degrees because angle DBC is equal to angle ABE. This is an example of inscribed angle, angle ACB. And what is inscribed angle? It is an angle whose vertex is on the circle and whose sides contains chords of the circle. So the chords are segment CA and segment CB. How to identify the measure of the arc AB? So the rule that is inscribed angle theorem. It means the measure of the inscribed angle is equal to 1/2 the measure of the intercepted arc. So it means the measure of the angle ACB, that is inscribed angle, is equal to 1/2 the measure of the arc AB. So example, if the measure of the arc AB is equal to 140 degrees, so it means 140 degrees times 1/2. So 140 times 1/2 or 140 divided by 2. So the measure of the angle ACB is equal to 70 degrees. What if the given is the measure of the angle ACB? So the value of the angle ACB is equal to 42 degrees. So we need to multiply it by 2. So 42 times 2, the answer is equal to 84 degrees. So the measure of the arc AB is equal to 84 degrees. Given the diagram, let us identify the value of the arcs and angles. So let us identify the measure of the arc CG. So BCG is a semicircle. So semicircle is equal to 180 degrees. So let us solve. 180 degrees minus 150, so that is equal to 30 degrees. So the measure of the arc CG is equal to 30 degrees. How about this one? The measure of the arc GA, so this is arc GA. So the semicircle is arc GAB. So arc GAB is equal to 180 degrees. So 180 degrees minus 80 is equal to 100 degrees. So arc GA is equal to 100 degrees. How about the measure of the angle AGB? So that is inscribed angle. So if that is inscribed angle, we need to divide it by 2. So 80 divided by 2, so the answer is equal to 40 degrees. So the measure of the angle AGB is equal to 40 degrees. How about the measure of the angle BGC? So again, this is inscribed angle, so we need to divide it by 2. So 150 divided by 2, so the answer is equal to 75 degrees. So the measure of the angle BGC is equal to 75 degrees. So, what if ganito yung figure natin? So, what could be the solution? So, the solution, the angles subtended by the same arc theorem. So, it means inscribed angles that intercept the same arc are congruent. So, in the circle G, so this is circle G, the angle CAB intercept the minor arc that is arc BC. So, this one. And then another, the angle CDB intercept the minor arc BC. So therefore, angle CAB is congruent to angle CDB. So it means if the value of angle CDB is equal to 7 degrees, so it means angle CAB is also equal to 7 degrees because angle CAB is congruent to angle CDB. Another example, in circle G, the measure of the angle CAD is equal to 6x degree, while the measure of the angle CBD is equal to 5x degree plus 10 degree. Let us find the measure of the angle CAD and the measure of the angle CBD and then arc DC. So what could be the solution to identify the x degree? So the solution, the angle subtended by the same arc theorem. So it means the measure of the angle CAD is equal to the measure of the angle CBD. So let us proceed. Let us copy. So 6x degree and then copy angle CBD. So that is 5x degree plus 10 degrees. So let us combine like terms. 6x degree, positive 5 going to left. So change the sign. So that becomes negative 5x degree. Bring down 10 degrees. 6 minus 5 is 1x degree. No need to write 1. Automatically, there's 1 here. So, x degree is equal to 10 degrees. So, let us proceed. Let us identify the angle CAD. Replace x degree by 10 degrees. So, 6 times 10, the answer is equal to 60 degrees. So, the measure of the angle CAD is equal to 60 degrees. How about this one? Without solving, automatically, the measure of the angle CBD is also equal to 60 degrees because the angles subtended by the same arc theorem. If we want to try to check, so let us check. The measure of the angle CBD is equal to 5x degree plus 10 degrees. Let us replace x degree by 10 degrees. So that becomes 5 times 10 degrees plus 10 degrees. 5 times 10 is 50 plus 10. So 50 plus 10, the answer is equal also to 60 degrees. So the measure of the angle CBD is also equal to 60 degrees. How about the measure of the arc DC? So the measure of the arc DC is equal to the twice of the measure of the arc CAD, or we may use arc CBD. So it means 60 times 2, so the answer is equal to 120 degrees. So the measure of the arc DC is equal to 120 degrees. Given the diagram, let us find the value of the measure of the angle ATB and the measure of the arc BC. If arc AB is equal to 80 degrees and the angle ADC is equal to 70 degrees, so let us first identify the measure of the angle ATB. So the formula equals 1/2 times the measure of the arc AB. the value of the arc AB is equal to 80 degrees. So we need to multiply it by 1/2 or divide it by 2. So 80 times 1/2, the answer is equal to 40 degrees. So the measure of the angle ATB is equal to 40 degrees. Next, we need to identify the measure of the arc BC. But before that, we need to identify the measure of the arc AC. So if this is inscribed angle, so the inscribed angle ADC. So the formula, the measure of the arc AC is equal to the twice of the angle ADC. So it means the angle ADC is equal to 70 degrees. So 2 times 70 degrees, the answer is equal to 140 degrees. So the measure of the arc AC is equal to 140 degrees. We need to identify now the measure of the arc BC. So arc BC is equal to the arc AC minus the arc AB. So the arc AC is equal to 140 degrees minus the arc AB is equal to 80 degrees. 140 minus 80 is equal to 60 degrees. So arc BC, the measure of the arc BC is equal to 60 degrees. In this example, it's a semicircle theorem. So it means any angle inscribed in a semicircle, then the angle is a right angle. So this one is the right angle. So that is angle ABC. Angle ABC is an inscribed angle in the semicircle. Therefore, the measure of the angle is equal to 90 degrees. Given the diagram, let us find the value of the arcs and angles. So let us see the measure of the arc AB. So this is arc AB. So let us get the inscribed angle. So the inscribed angle is angle AEB. That is equal to 45 degrees. So 45 times 2, the answer is equal to 90 degrees. So the measure of the arc AB is equal to 90 degrees. How about the measure of the angle ADC? So this is angle ADC. As you can see, this is a right angle. So that is equal to 90 degrees. How about the measure of the angle ABC? Measure of the angle ABC is a right angle. So it means measure of the angle ABC is also equal to 90 degrees. How about the measure of the arc CDA? So the measure of the arc CDA, so let us see what could be the inscribed angle. So the inscribed angle is angle ABC. And the inscribed angle ABC is equal to 90 degrees. So 90 times 2, the answer is equal to 180 degrees. Or as you can see, measure of the arc CDA is a semicircle, and a semicircle is equal to 180 degrees. So let us practice what you have learned about the inscribed angles and arcs. Instruction, given the circle B, let us identify the value of the angles and arc. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.